वेलकम इन पीडियाटिक लेक्चर सीरीज। माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर सुनील नाथा मस्के, प्रोफेसर इन पीडियाटिक्स एज वेल एज डीन इन डॉक्टर विठ्ठलराव विखे पाटिल फाउंडेशन मेडिकल कॉलेज एंड हॉस्पिटल अहमदनगर। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द कंजेनाइटल हार्ट डिसीजेस एंड दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द कंजेनाइटल हार्ट डिसीज इन चिल्ड्रन। इन लास्ट लेक्चर सीरीज वी हैव सीन embryology of heart, then anatomy of heart, then fetal circulation, neonatal circulation, that is the physiology of heart, then how the various foramina overlay, ductus arteriosus, venosus, they will continue as remnants in adult life. Now we have seen the congenital heart diseases, which are divided as per NADA's criteria and diagnosed into left to right shunt as a cyanotic congenital heart disease and right to left shunt as a cyanotic congenital heart disease. We have seen in a cyanotic congenital heart disease, ASD, then ventricular septal defect, that is the VSD, then we have seen the patent ductus arteriosus, that is the PDA, then obstructive lesions like pulmonary stenosis, aortic stenosis, and very important is the coarctation of aorta. Now we are going to see the cyanotic congenital heart disease, that is the part 2 of this lecture. Cyanotic congenital heart diseases are divided into two groups depending on the pulmonary blood flow. If it is more, it is increased, it is due to the transposition of great arteries, truncus arteriosus, single ventricle, total anomalous pulmonary venous return. Or if the pulmonary blood flow is decreased, it is mainly due to the phallocytology, tricuspid atresia, Epstein anomaly, and pulmonary atresia. Now we will see one by one. Now, first is the Fallot tetralogy, which is common cyanotic congenital heart disease. The word Fallot is actually the name of the French physician and cardiologist, 18 Louis Arthur Fallot, who in 1988 diagnosed and invented these cases. Fallot tetralogy is near about 10% of all the forms of congenital heart disease and is the most common congenital heart disease which gives rise to the cyanosis after first year of life. It affects more boys than the girls. Fallot tetralogy itself suggests it has four components. One is the ventricular septal defect. Second one is obstruction to right ventricular outflow. Third one is the overriding of aorta. And fourth one is the right ventricular hypertrophy. These are the four components of Fallot tetralogy. Clinical features. In this case, there is the appearance of cyanosis after 1 year of age. Child have hypoxic smells. There are low birth weight or developmental delay. Child is azifatigability, cyanosis, clubbing, respiratory difficulty, that is tachypnea, polycythemia you will get. On physical examination, there is a right ventricular tapping type of apex beat in the left sternal border, systolic thrill in upper and mid left sternal border, ejection click which is originating from the aorta, single second heart sound due to absent pulmonary component. Also, you can get the loud ejection type of systolic murmur which is best heard in the middle and upper left sternal border because of this pulmonary stenosis. And intensity of murmur depends on the severity of pulmonary stenosis or right ventricular outlet obstruction. If there is a more severe obstruction, you will get the shorter or soft murmur and vice versa. In severe type, murmur is absent. There are variants of this Fallot tetralogy. One is a cyanotic or pink Fallot, where the right ventricular outlet obstruction is mild, so So clinical picture just resembled to ventricular septal defect. In pathology of Hallett's, component ASD, that is the atrial septal defect, is added to four components. In pathology of Hallett's with pulmonary atresia also you will get. Sometimes pathology of Hallett's with absent pulmonary valve you will get. And pathology of Hallett with absence branch pulmonary artery. These are the few variants of the Hallett's tetralogy. There are certain syndromes which are associated with this Hallett's tetralogy, like fetal hydantin syndrome, fetal carbamazepine syndrome, fetal alcohol syndrome, maternal phenylketonuria valve defects, CATCH22, CATCH, that is a cardiac defect, abnormal facies, thymic hypoplasia, cleft palate, and hypocalcemia. These are associated with the Hallett's tetralogy. Now, when the case of Hallett's tetralogy comes, we have to do the certain investigation like hemoglobin estimation. We give rise to the polycythemia because of cyanosis, and also there is anemia due to relative iron deficiency. ECG shows right axis deviation and right ventricular hypertrophy. X-ray heart size is normal, decreased pulmonary vascular marking, and the typical shape of the heart you will see in this slide. That is a boot-shaped heart or Karen-Seibert heart. This is the concave main pulmonary artery segment with an upturned apex, which gives rise to the boot-shaped heart. There is the right atrial enlargement in 25% of the cases, and you can see right aortic arch in 25% of cases. Also, echocardiography and angiogram is diagnostic. Hypoxic pain. Once the Hallett's pathology patient comes, he gives the history of the hypoxic spells. These are also known as hypocyanotic or cyanotic or hypoxic spells. Mechanism is very simple. Secondary to infundibular spasm and or decreased systemic venous return with increased right to left shunting at VSD, which results in decreased pulmonary blood flow. Its incidence is common at the age of 2 to 4 months, usually occurs after crying, feeding or defecation, and it leads to the limpiness, convulsion and cerebrovascular accident. Sometimes death. In this case, in hypoxic space, there is a sudden onset of cyanosis and dyspnea. Sometimes there is an unconsciousness also, and there is a decreased intensity of systolic murmur. Hemodynamic is increased activity, increased respiration, increased venous return, fixed pulmonary blood flow, increase right to left ventricular shunt, and increase cyanosis. Now, the treatment is very simple for this, is the squatting. You have to keep the child in squatting or mid-chest position or sitting with flexed limb position, or mother can carry the child with folded limbs and others. The basic simple mechanism of this squatting or mid-chest position, it leads to the decreased venous return, it increases the systemic vascular resistance, it increases the pulmonary blood flow, and it ultimately leads to the decreased cyanosis. Treatment in hypoxic spell, one part we have seen that it is a squatting or knee chest position. Second, if it is not controlled, then you can do the morphine, 1-2 mg subcutaneously or intramuscularly, because oxygen has very little role. If there is a metabolic acidosis, you can give the soda bicarb, 1 ml per kg, 1 milliequivalent per kg, and still it is not responding, you can give the vasoconstrictors like phenylephrine, propranolol, or ketamine. Now, complication of Hallett's tetralogy. It leads to the erythrocytosis, brain abscess, acute gouty arthritis, infective endocarditis, cerebral vascular thrombosis, and delayed puberty. Now, treatment of Hallett's tetralogy. Medical treatment only involves the treatment of and prevention of hypoxic spells. For iron deficiency anemia, you can use iron supplementation. You can do the balloon dilatation of right ventricular outflow where there is obstruction, and good dental hygiene in order to prevent the infective endocarditis, and hematocrit should be maintained. But the major role is the systematic poor pulmonary shunts. In that, four types of shunts are there. Valve tussock shunt, where there is anastomosis between subclavian artery and ipsilateral pulmonary artery. And Gore-Tex interposition shunt, it is placed between subclavian and ipsilateral pulmonary artery. Watterson shunt, there is anastomosis between ascending aorta and right pulmonary artery. Watt shunt, It is anastomosis between descending aorta and left pulmonary artery. Here is Dr. Balog, who is performing the shunt surgery at Hopkins Institute. Can see the first female patient named Elin Saxon, who term as a fellow of trachology on 29 November at Johns Hopkins Hospital at Baltimore. Now, second cyanotic heart disease is tricuspid atresia. It is an uncommon form of congenital heart disease. It affects near about 5 in every 1 lakh live births. Here, the tricuspid wall is missing or abnormally developed. The defect blocks the blood flow from right atrium to the right ventricle because tricuspid wall lies between the right atrium and right ventricle. If the tricuspid wall does not open, the blood cannot flow from the right atrium to right ventricle, which ultimately cannot enter into the lung. Instead, the blood bypasses through the hole between right and left atrium, that is atrial septal defect, in the left atrium where it mixes both the oxygen-rich and oxygen-poor blood, and which leads to pushing the blood through left ventricle into the hole of the body. That means overall oxygen saturation of the blood in remaining body is lower. If the mother is suffering from the German measles, parent has a congenital heart disease, old parental age, maternal obesity, alcohol drinking, smoking, poorly controlled diabetes, some medications, and Down syndrome are the risk factors for this tricuspid atresia. In tricuspid atresia, child has a fatigue, poor growth, marked cyanosis from the birth. On ECG, there is a left axis deviation with right atrial enlargement and left ventricular hypertrophy. Chest X-ray shows decreased pulmonary blood flow and oligemic lung failure. Complications of tricuspid atresia are arrhythmia, chronic diarrhea, heart failure, ascites, pleural effusion, stroke, and sudden death. Treatment, first aim is to keep the ductus arteriosus open. For that purpose, you have to use the prostaglandin. And corrective surgery is done in the form of Glenn shunt or hemipontensure procedure. And later on, final step is the Fontan procedure. Prognosis is increased by surgery. Third cyanotic congenital heart disease is Epstein anomaly. It accounts less than 1% of total congenital heart defects. And here, there is a septal or posterior leaflet of the tricuspid wall are displaced downwards and towards the apex of the right ventricle of the heart. In 50% of the individuals with Epstein anomaly have an associated septum between right and left atrium, either ASD or patent foramina ovale. These are the Epstein right-sided and Epstein left-sided type. The child has intermittent cyanosis, multiple clicks, huge right atrium, third heart sound and fourth heart sounds are audible. Gallop rhythm is also there. Systolic murmur of tricuspid regurgitation you can hear. Right atrial hypertrophy, right ventricular conduction defect, and WPW syndrome can also occur. Now there are certain risk factors for this disease. That if the mother is on the lithium treatment in the first trimester of pregnancy, and those having the Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome are at risk of this Epstein anomaly. Chest X-ray is very typical, looking like pericardial effusion. It is a globe-shaped heart with narrow waist, where the pulmonary field shows either decrease or in normal vascularity. ECG shows Himalayan P waves and low amplitude QRS complex. Treatment is giving the procainamide and surgery. Now, fourth one is the pulmonary atresia. It is a congenital heart disease. It is very critical, where the pulmonary wall, which controls the blood flow from the right ventricle to the main pulmonary artery, there is an atresia. That's why there is unable to push the blood from the right ventricle into the lungs. The foramen ovale often remains open to allow the blood flow to the lungs. There are types of pulmonary atresia, where there is an intact ventricular septum or there is a defect in the interventricular septum. Child has a cyanosis, respiratory difficulty, feeding difficulty, breathing difficulty, Pulse oximetry is very diagnostic, chest X-ray, ECG and cardiac catheterization are also necessary. Complications are delayed growth and development, seizures, stroke, infective endocarditis, cardiac failure and death. Treatment depends on keeping the patency of the ductus arteriosus by giving the prostaglandin and shunt surgery to help the flow with the help of Fontan procedure. Next, cyanotic heart disease is TGV, commonly known as transposition of great arteries. Aorta is connected to right ventricle and pulmonary artery is connected to left ventricle. This situation is totally reverse of normal. In normal, aorta is connected to left ventricle and pulmonary artery is normally connected to right ventricle. But in TGV, there is a reversal, aorta to right ventricle and pulmonary artery to left ventricle, which leads to oxygen poor blood is sent to the body instead of going to the lungs, and oxygen rich blood goes to the lung instead of going to the body. Like this figure, aorta emerges from the right ventricle, pulmonary artery emerges from left ventricle. There is a ventricular septal defect, atrial septal defect, and patent ductus arteriosus. Child is cyanotic immediately after birth. Tachypnea, tachycardia, and poor feeding are there. Complications will be heart valve problems, arrhythmias, cardiac failure, lung problems, and mortality is also high in this case. There are two types, liver transfusion and dextrotransfusion. Liver transfusion is a rare type of transposition of great arteries, and it is a congenitally corrected transposition. In this case, two ventricles are also switched so that left ventricle is on the heart's right side, which receives blood from the right atrium, and the right ventricle is on the heart's left side, which receives blood from the left atrium. Because of this nature's correction, it is congenitally corrected. Pupils are not diagnosed until in the adulthood age because there are no symptoms. In dextro position, just we have seen before the liver position, these are the complete switching of the circulation occurs, where the aorta arises from the right side and pulmonary artery arises from the left side. Investigations like pulse oximetry, chest X-ray, ECG, echo, cardiac catheterization are useful. Treatment keeping all the foramina open is the main aim, is the prostaglandin E1 aortic balloon arterial septostomy and arterial switch surgery is ultimate treatment. Now truncus arteriosus. It is also congenital heart disease which gives the cyanosis present at the birth but occurs less than 1% of the cases, where it truncus arteriosus fails to properly divide into pulmonary trunk and aorta. Single blood vessel, truncus arteriosus comes out of the right and left ventricle instead of two normal vessels, that is artery and aorta. This results in one arterial trunk arising from the heart, providing mixed blood to the coronary arteries, pulmonary arteries, and systemic circulation. And commonly, it is associated with chromosome 20q11 deletion, which is a DJOS syndrome. Single artery arising from the two ventricles, which give rise to both the aortic and pulmonary vessel. There is an abnormal truncal wall also occurs. And 30% of the cases, there is a right-sided aortic arch. Also, you can get a large VSD, pulmonary hypertension, complete mixing of the blood, and right to left shunting. Mechanism we have seen just now. Symptoms are cyanosis, growth failure, fatigue, poor feeding, tachypnea, dyspnea, clubbing. And main complication is pulmonary hypertension. Treatment is a corrective surgery. Now, hypoplastic left heart syndrome. It is also known as single ventricle. It is one of the type. It is very rare type, 2 to 3% of the cases, and it may affect the left ventricle, aorta, aortic wall, or mitral wall. There is often ASD is there. Closing of ductus arteriosus in the heart that is severely underdeveloped result into cyanosis and respiratory distress, which leads to the cardiogenic shock and death. In this case, peripheral pulses are very weak and cold, where the left side of the heart cannot pump the oxygen-rich blood into the body properly. ECG shows right axis deviation, right ventricular hypertrophy. Chest X-ray shows large heart, increased pulmonary vasculature. Treatment, there are multiple surgeries are required to restore the heart function in normal position. bidirectional glenchant fossa or a fountain fossa. Prognosis depends on the health and underlying condition of the child. Single ventricle is similar to first one, but just other defects like tricuspid atresia, mitral wall atresia, hypoplastic left side, double inlet left ventricle, double outlet right ventricle, cardiac heterotaxity can occur with this, and ultimately corrective procedure is the fountain procedure. Now, TAPVR, total anomalous pulmonary venous return or connection. It is rare cyanotic congenital heart disease where all four pulmonary veins are malpositioned and makes anomalous connection to the systemic venous circulation. Normally, pulmonary veins return oxygenated blood from the lungs to the left atrium, where it can be then pumped to the rest of the body. Patent foramen overlap, patent ductus arteriosus, ASD may be present, otherwise this condition is very patent. There are three types. Supracardiac occurs in 50% of the cases, where blood drains to one of the innominate vein, brachiocephalic vein, or to the supravena vein. In cardiac case, 20%, blood drains into the coronary sinus or directly into the right atrium. In intradiaphragmatic type, 20%, where the blood drains into portal or hepatic vein, or in 10%, it may be mixed. TAPVC can occur with obstruction, which occurs when the anomalous veins enter the vessel at an acute angle and cause pulmonary venous hypertension and cyanosis at birth. There's a loud S1, fixed split of the second heart sound, Galaf heart sound, systolic ejection murmur, cardiomegaly, right axis deviation on ECG. X-ray is very typical of the figure 8 configuration because of right ventricular hypertrophy. Child has a cyanosis, tachypnea, dyspnea at birth. This is a figure 8 heart. Treatment, giving the oxygen, prostaglandin therapy. Now, this completes the congenital heart diseases of the children. We have divided cyanotic and acyanotic congenital heart disease in two broad categories. If there is obstruction and left to right shunt, and right to left shunt with decreased or increased pulmonary blood flow. Thank you.